In this video, we will create a stylized 3D living room in the free 3D software, Blender. Doesn't matter if you are a beginner or an intermediate Blender user. I can say with utmost confidence, by the end of this three-part tutorial series, you'll have gained the knowledge to create a 3D model, which no man has ever tried before. Here I am on Blender version 3.0, but you should be able to follow this tutorial with the newer Blender versions as well. Before we do anything, head over to the Edit menu, then Preferences, System, and then under Memory and Limits, set the Undo steps to a higher value. By doing this, you should be able to use the Undo shortcut Ctrl+Z that many times. Now if you see a Save button in the bottom left, click on that. I don't have it because I've turned on autosave. Once done, you can close this window. To rotate the view, click and drag the middle mouse button. Shift plus middle mouse button will move the view. Scrolling the mouse wheel will let you zoom in or out, and left clicking over the objects will select them. If you press N on the keyboard, it'll bring some menus in the sidebar. Here under Items, you can put certain values which will be applied to the selected object. Now under Dimensions, let's put the X and Y value to 10 feet, then press Enter. Blender will automatically convert it to meters, and the Z value to 9 feet. We cannot edit our model in the object mode, so with the cube still selected, press Tab to enter its edit mode. Press 3 to enable face selection, and select the top face. Then hold down Shift, and select the side faces. Press X, and select faces to delete them. Now with the bottom face selected, press P, and select Selection to separate it from the original model. If you press Tab to go back to object mode, you will see they are now two separate objects. With the side faces selected, head over to this wrench-looking icon in the Properties Editor. Under Add Modifier, select Solidify. This will help us add thickness to the model. Drag over the thickness slider to change it, or you can type in manually, -0.3 in my case. The problem here is that the thickness isn't as uniform as we would like it to happen. Marking the even thickness option will fix this issue. Now select the bottom face, and then shift select the walls. Under the drop-down in modifier properties, select copy to selected so you don't have to repeat the same steps again. Before we go any further, let's go ahead and apply the modifiers of both the objects. Right now, our models are very sharp, so to add a bit of roundness, press Ctrl+2. This will add a subdivision modifier of subdivision level 2, but this is not the result we are looking for, so to get what we want, we need to add another modifier called bevel. Nothing happened because modifiers need to be in the right order, so drag the bevel modifier on top of the subsurf modifier. We are still getting some shading issues because right now everything is being beveled. Edges, as well as vertices. We need to tell Blender what needs to be beveled. So first of all, change the limit method to weight. Then press Tab to enter its edit mode. Pressing A will select everything. Under Items and then under Edges Data, slide the bevel weight all the way up to 1. This will tell Blender to bevel only the selected edges, not the vertices. In the Bevel Properties, increase the segment to 2. Now if you look at the model from a side profile, you will notice there is some curvature going on. To remove this, under Profile slide the shape value to the maximum. You can also control how much bevel you need by changing the amount value. Now we want the floor to have the same properties, so select it, then shift select the wall to make that active. You could copy each modifier separately like before. But if you want all the modifiers to get copied at once, press Ctrl+L, and select Copy Modifiers. The modifiers have been copied, but we still need to tell Blender which part of the new model needs to be beveled. So Tab for Edit Mode, A to select all, and Bevel Weight to 1. Back in Object Mode, if you right-click and select Shade Smooth, it will remove the flat-shaded look from the selected model. Now enter Edit Mode of the wall. Then press 1 to enable vertex selection, Alt+Z for X-ray mode, so we can select the parts from the other side without rotating the view. Now left-click drag over the bottom vertices to select them, then click on the negative Y button here to switch to the front view. and from the drop-down above, activate the Move tool. Dragging the blue arrow will move the selected on Z-axis. While moving, hold down Shift key for precise movement. Back in object mode, select both the objects and move them up on Z-axis. Hold down Ctrl key while moving to move them up in smaller increments of 1 unit. Exit X-ray with Alt plus Z. It's a good practice to name your models as you go. So even if the scene gets too complex later on, we can easily locate the objects by their names. Select the walls and press F2 to rename it. Select the floor and name it as well. Now to enter the camera view, click on the camera icon over here. Then in the output properties, change the resolution to something square. And if the camera is selected, you will see camera properties over here. Change the lens type to orthographic. Press G to move the camera such that the room is at the center. Then you can change the scale through here. Now take the cursor near the editor boundary and right-click once you see the double-sided arrow. Select Vertical Split, and left-click somewhere on left to create a new editor. Now with the cursor on left viewport, press N to hide the side menus. And then press T to hide the toolbar. Bring the cursor over the top, and scroll to see the menus on the right. Then hide the gizmos and disable the overlays. Now press Shift plus A to bring the Add menu and add another cube. I'll change its Z value to 0.07. An X and Y value to 1.7. From the front view, I'll move this up a bit. Control plus 2 to add subsurf modifier. Tab to enter its edit mode, and then Ctrl R to add a loop cut. Left click to make the cut, and right click to cancel its movement. Then Ctrl plus B to bevel the loop to create support loops. Add a loop on other side as well with Ctrl R. And then bevel it with Ctrl plus B. Also add a horizontal loop to control the bottom. Back in object mode, let's name this as rug. Whenever we scale any object in object mode, we need to apply it. Because if we don't, many tools and modifier doesn't work properly. To do that, you have to select the object, press Ctrl plus A, and select scale. If I undo, you might see the difference. Also select the others, and apply scale to them as well. The position of the 3D cursor tells Blender where to add a new object. And it can be changed with Shift plus right-clicking. Now let's add a mesh plane. Its X and Y length will be 1.9 and 0.9 respectively. Apply the scale with Ctrl plus A. Then in edit mode, move this up a bit on Z-axis. Press E to extrude it up. Add a vertical loop in middle, and then bevel it with Ctrl plus B. Add another one on the side, and slide it a bit. Press 3 for face selection, and shift select the side faces. Extrude them up on Z axis. Then back in object mode, shift select the walls, and press Ctrl plus L. Select copy modifiers. And in edit mode, press A to select everything, and then increase the bevel weight. In the bevel properties, you can control the bevel amount if needed. Let's name this as couch. To make the seat, select the middle face, and duplicate using Shift plus D. Right-click to cancel the movement, then E to extrude it up. Press A to select everything, and set the bevel weight to 1. Then in object mode, switch to top view, and move the couch a bit. In its edit mode, switch to X-ray view with Alt plus Z. And select the bottom corner face. Duplicate it with Shift plus D, and then press P, and select selection to separate it. Exit edit mode, select the leg part. And enter its edit mode. Press A to select everything, and G to move it. Now press S to scale this down a bit, then exit X-ray view. And press E to extrude down. Press forward slash to isolate the selection. Now let's delete the top face so we don't have to add support loop there. So select the top face. Press X to bring delete menu, and select faces to delete the face. And we don't need the bevel modifier, so close it as well. Now press A to select all. Right click and select subdivide. Now press 2 for edge selection. And Alt left click on the central edge to select the loop. Move this down to control the bottom part. Now tab to exit edit mode, and forward slash to exit isolate view. Then with the leg selected, add a mirror modifier to it. Both the X and Y need to be turned on. Now shift right click on the seat to place the 3D cursor there. Then add a cube to make the cushion. Set the dimensions. Control 2 to add subsurf modifier. And in edit mode, add loop cut with Control plus R, and bevel with Control plus B. In the isolate view, select the top and bottom faces, and scale them up on Z axis by pressing S and then Z. In object mode, rotate it on X axis by pressing R then X. Adjust the position. Now after naming this with F2, duplicate it using Alt plus D, and move it on X axis. Now add another cube to make a throw pillow. Scale it down. And then apply the scale with Control plus A. Control plus 2 to add subsurf modifier. In edit mode, right click and subdivide it. Press 1 for vertex selection, and Alt Z for X-ray mode. Shift select the corner vertices. And scale them down. In object mode, rotate this a bit. Then name the object. And duplicate using Alt plus D. Now select the cushions, pillows, legs, and lastly the couch. Press Ctrl plus P, and select object to make it parent to the rest. With the parent selected, pressing Shift plus right square bracket will select the children as well. Duplicate the couch using Shift plus D. Delete the cushion and pillow from one side. And then in edit mode, with X-ray enabled, bring the right side closer. Back in object mode, select the legs and move it to the center. Then in its edit mode, make sure everything is selected and bring it inside the couch. Now with the couch selected, press Shift plus right square bracket to select the remaining. And move this by dragging the white circle. Then rotate with R, 90 for 90 and Z for Z axis. Now with the cursor on the wall, add another cube to create a picture frame. Set these dimensions. In edit mode, select the front face and press I to inset it. If you look carefully, you can see that the inset isn't uniform. These kinds of issues arise if the model has been scaled in object mode and it's not been applied. So Ctrl Z to undo. In object mode, press Ctrl A and select scale to apply it. Now if you inset, the issue is no more there. Then press E to extrude it inside, A to select all, and slide the bevel weight value to max. Then in object mode, shift select the walls. Ctrl L and copy modifiers. After naming the frame, switch to right side view. Then with the wall selected, press Tab to enter its edit mode. Ctrl R to add a loop cut. We are going to create a window here. Right now the loop isn't straight due to the edge on the right. So to make it straight, press S, Y, and 0. Then press Ctrl B to bevel it. Now add one horizontal loop and bevel that as well. Turn on face selection with 3, and then select the faces in front and back. Then press Ctrl E to bring the edge context menu and select bridge edge loops. This will create a hollow shape. To get rid of this shading issue, we need to add bevel to the newly created edges. So select all with A and increase the bevel weight. Now with face selection enabled, Alt left click over here to select this face loop. Shift plus D to duplicate it and right click to cancel movement. Then press P and select selection to separate it. In object mode, let's rename this with F2. Since some of the faces of window are overlapping with the faces of wall, this shading issue is happening. To fix this, select everything in edit mode and scale this down a bit. Now press S and X to scale it on X axis. Then Alt plus E to bring up extrude menu and select extrude faces along normals. Left click after extruding a bit. And to get rid of the shading issue, select all with A and increase the bevel weight. Now we need a glass pane right in the middle of the window. So press Shift plus S to bring Snap Pie menu and select cursor to select it. Once the cursor is at center of selected, add a mesh plane. And to sharpen the corners, instead of adding loop cuts, press Shift plus E to add a crease. You can control the crease value from the operator panel, as well as through the side panel. Now rotate this 90 degrees on Y axis by pressing R, 90, and Y. Scale if necessary, and move it to the front a bit. If you think the frame is too thin, then you can select the outside face loop. Press S to scale. And then Shift plus X to restrict scaling on X axis. Let's wrap it up for today. But before exiting Blender, don't forget to save the progress. To do that, head over to File, select Save As. Select the file folder and name the project. Then hit Save. Hope you were able to follow up till now. If you did, hit those like and subscribe buttons. And turn on notifications to get notified when I upload the remaining parts.